guys, welcome to Simplified by Jinal Shah. Here we come again with another book review of textbook of homeopathic therapeutics in ophthalmology by Dr. Rohit Deshpande. This is the second book, the latest one. I think, or I have a gut feeling that more books are yet to come by this author, and I will be genuinely waiting. Again, I would like to thank Dr. Rohit Deshpande for sending these books over so that I could have a read. Although I'm a little jealous that I wish I had it last year when I had ophthalmology as a subject. But anyways, it will be helpful in the clinical practice, most definitely. This book has, 37 clinical conditions, as you can see here in the index page. Starting from amaurosis, there is amblyopia, blepharitis, there is cataract, cancerous eye, chalazion, conjunctivitis, so on and so forth, iritis, keratitis. Last is weakness of vision. That total ups or sums up to about 37 clinical conditions, after which there is an introduction page, and then we start with the therapeutic section. Now, as a homeopath, we know that therapeutics is not just this remedy for this condition. That is totally not true. And the author clearly mentions here that in the section under each disease or under each clinical condition, he has mentioned around 10 homeopathic remedies, which are most indicated and clinically verified by the author. Apart from these 10 remedies, if you have a patient and the totality is suggesting some other remedy, then it is still a valid application. You can still most definitely give the 11th remedy. And of course, the constitution. Constitution cannot be put down into the therapeutic. So constitutionally or mental picture wise, he is some other remedy. Then you have to most definitely give that. And that is clearly mentioned in the book, which is a very good point, because people do not really understand therapeutics and they blindly keep it as specifics, which is not true. Now, starting with the clinical condition, like the first one, the author has mentioned a few common symptoms or a general how to diagnose that condition. Later on, he mentions top 10 homeopathic remedies for same, which, like I said, are most clinically verified by the author. And then, as a student, even I do this sometimes, that I write everything I know about the drug into the therapeutic part. But here he has made sure that first of all, he has mentioned the eye symptoms. It may not be very clear here. After eye symptoms, there are the general symptoms, that is food desire, thirst, whether he's chilly or hot, food aversion, food disagrees, and the modalities section. So it kind of fits the acute totality of our prescription method. And that same pattern is carried out throughout the book in all 37 clinical conditions. So in case if I land up with a patient having a certain clinical condition and I do not get a proper history or do not get proper symptoms, then I have at least 10 remedies on the basis on which I can ask him questions. And it can be a second thought or an afterthought that if nothing fits, I can try at least one of them. Again, this book is available on Amazon. You can order it from Amazon. You can either search it by the name or by author's name. Very easy to order from Amazon. I would definitely suggest you to have this as a copy if you are either giving exams of your ophthalmology or if your clinical practice has a lot of eye-related patients. You most definitely have it.